Hi dear students, today we'll start a new video of the numericals on capacitors and capacitance that is already written here. I think the theory portion you have already read. Here we have to do some numericals and that should be helpful for you to do the numericals are given in your book. So the first numericals we have to do here, it is written 2 capacitors of capacitance 3 microfarad and 6 microfarad are charged to potentials of 2 volt and 5 volt respectively. So what information is given that we have to write down here? So given information is 2 capacitors. So one we have to take C1, that is 3 microfarad, and another is C2, which is 6 microfarad. And they are connected with different potential, that C1 is connected with V1, that is 2 volt, what is written here, and V2, what is 5 volt. Okay. Now, the question is, these 2 charged capacitors then connected in series, find the potential across 2 capacitors now. Now, the question is that, when these 2 capacitors are just connected in series, then they should have same amount of charge. So let's see what charge is produced due to this potential. So we know Q is equals to C into V. So from here we can write Q1 is equals to C1 into V1. So what is the value of C1 here? It is 3 microfarad. Okay. And it is 2 volt. Okay. So the answer will be 6 microcoulomb because we have not changed the microfarad. Otherwise, if you want to change, if you have to, you have to multiply with it 10 to the power minus 6. Next Q2, that is C2, V2, and here it is C2 is 6 and V2 is 5. So it is 30 microcoulomb. Okay. Now, when they are connected in series, definitely their total charge should be added. So we can write total charge Q equals to Q1 plus Q2. So what is Q here? 1 here, that is 6. Q2 is 30. So it is 36 microcoulomb. Now the question is that these 2 capacitors are connected in series. Okay. So when they are connected in series, so definitely their total charge should be same. That is 36 microcoulomb. We know that if the 2 capacitors are connected in series, then the total charge should be same. Okay. So here, if I want to find the potential across each, so for C1, we are assuming the potential is V1. For C2, the potential across it is V2. So if I want to find V1, so V1 equals to, definitely it should be Q by C1. What is the value of Q? That is 36. What is the value of C1? The value of C1 is 3. And it is 12 volt. Why it is 12 volt? Because it is 36 microcoulomb and 3 microfarad. So this will be cancelled out. That's why 12 volt. If I'm talking about V2, so V2 equals to Q by C2. Q equals to 36 and it is 6. Okay. So it should be 36 microcoulomb and 6 microfarad and it is 6 volt. And if it is asked, so it is only asked find the potential across each of the 2 capacitors. So one it is 12 volt and one it is 6 volt. If it is asked total potential difference in series combination, so then total potential difference will be V1 plus V2, that is 12 plus 6, that is 18 volt. This is not asked. So we have done it for your knowledge. Okay. So question number 1 has done. Now we'll go for question number 2. I think it is easier for you. So we'll come to question number 2. So by seeing the question, I think it is very easier for you. The value of C1 and C2, it is given to you. C1 equals to 3 picofarad. This P stands for pico, and pico means 10 to the power minus 12. Okay. C2, calculate the equivalent capacitance of the given network between the points A and B. So here number is also mentioned. It is A and B. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and then 6. Now if you see the diagram, here 2, 3 and 4, they are connected in series, end to end contact. So we can write 2, 3 and 4 connected in series. So if they are connected in series, so let's, it will be CS. So CS equals to 1 by CS equals to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. Exactly opposite to the resistance that we have done when we have learned the theory. So what is the value of C1 here? So C1 is 3. What is the value of C2? It is 2. And then it is 3. So we don't need to change it picofarad to farad. It is not needed here. Okay, because the equivalent resistance, equivalent capacitance also we have to calculate in picofarad. So here it will be 6, the LCM, 2 plus 1 plus 2. Okay, so it should be, so 3 2s are 6, 2 or 2 3s are, I'm sorry, it is 3. Okay, and then it will be 7 by 6 picofarad. 7 by 6 picofarad. So 2, 3, 4. Okay, this thing is completed. So now the diagram looks like this. This one, here it is C2. Okay, so this is 1, this is 5, and this is 6. And along with it, one another resistance has come. Because these three, we have to together, this one, assume that value, we have to take 7. Okay, so its value is 7 by 6 picofarad. And now see, 7 by 6 and here this 5, that this one is C2. These are connected in parallel. So here, we can write CP is equals to, I'm sorry, it's 7 by 6. So here we have to take a reverse of it. Otherwise, there will be a problem. So it is 1 by CS. It will be 6 by 7. I'm very sorry. It is 6 by 7 picofarad. That is your CS. Okay. And then CP equals to CS. That means this one plus C2. What is the value of CS? It is 6 by 7. What is the value of C2? C2 is 2. Okay, so it is clearly that 20 by 7 picofarad. Okay, now you see this C1 and this C1, they are connected in series with a resistance 20 by 7 picofarad. And this is also C1, this is also C1. So definitely it is connected in series. Okay. So as it is connected in series, so we have to put the value here. Okay. So let's put the value. 1 by C is equals to, so let's, the whole resistance will be C. So it is 1 by C1, that is 1 by 3 plus 20 by 7, whenever we have to take the reverse of it, it is 7 by 20 plus 1 by 3 again. Okay, so the place is very small. I just want to do it together. So LCM is 60, 3, 20. So it is 20, 21 plus 20. So 1 by C equals to 61 by 60. And then C equals to 60 by 61 picofarad. Actually the place is small, that's why I just want to put everything here. Okay, and here we have to make reverse, otherwise there will be problem. Okay, I think it is clear. So we are coming to numerical number 3. So if you see the diagram, in numerical number 3, this type of diagram we have done in resistances. So here we are talking about capacitors. Okay, so let's see. Here this point is A, this is C, this is D, and this is B. Now you see A and D is connected with a conductor. A and D is connected with a conductor. What is the meaning of it? The meaning is that A and D both are same points. Okay, A and D both are same points. Okay, so let's modify the diagram again. So this point is X. We are coming to the point A, and now we have to see our resistance, that is our capacitor, it is 2 microfarad. So let's join it. It is our 2 microfarad capacitor, and this point should be C. Okay, now I have already told which one point is A. D is also same point. Why? Because they are connected it by a conductor. So A and D is the same point. So another resistor, another capacitor, why I'm telling resistor, I don't know. Another capacitor of 3 microfarad, it is starting from D and ended at C. So here D to C means A to C. So here we can say that this point is D, and D to C. Okay, so here it is your another capacitor, that is 3 microfarad. Okay, now coming to C and B. So here also it is connected by a conductor. So B and C, it is the same point. Now we have to see the last capacitor, that is 5 microfarad. It is connected in between D and B. And which point is B? We can say that point is C. So that point we can say it is B, and it is connected B to D, just like this. Okay, now you see our diagram is modified. Okay, and now from B to Y, one capacitor of 10 microfarad is connected. Simple thing. So our diagram is modified. We can draw it like this way also, that one, two, three. Okay, and here another capacitor, X and Y. It is 2, it is 3, it is 5. So these three are connected in parallel, and with it is connected in series. So its modified diagram is this. I think it is clear. So they are connected in parallel. So we can write CP, that should be equals to 2 plus 3 plus 5. So it is 10 microfarad. So now it should be 10 and another 10, it is connected in series. So it is X, it is Y. So 1 by CS equals to 1 by 10 plus 1 by 10. So we can write it is 1 by 5. So CS equals to 5 microfarad. Okay, our answer is completed. So this type of numerical, mainly where we have to use the diagram to find the equivalent capacitance. Okay, and here if it is a potential difference is given between them, then we have to multiply with the capacitor, with the equivalent capacitance, and we can find out the total charge. Okay, so everything as per equation we have to do. Okay, now coming to question number 4. Here you see this diagram, and here you have to see at the end some dotted lines are there. So this dotted line represents that this setup, it should continue. Here you see 2 microfarad, 1 microfarad, 1 microfarad. This part, it is repeated in the next part. That is 2, 1, 1. Again, it is repeated here, 2, 1, 1. Here also, it should be repeated 2, 1, 1. And it should continue. This type of diagram or this type of numerical is known as ladder numerical. Ladder. We all know about ladder. Okay, so it is used to move in a height. So here, continuous repetition of same loop. So it is, you can say this one, it is a loop, and that loop is repeated same time, continuously. Okay, and here what we have to do, how we can able to find the resultant capacitance or equivalent capacitance. So for that case, we have to assume one thing. What assumption we have to take? So as the loop is repeated, so the loop should be represented by a constant capacitance C, let. What we have done? Now, as this is repeated continuously, so instead of taking this loop, okay, so this loop, that is 2 microfarad, here it is 1, and here it is 1. And it is connected. So this is the loop which is repeated continuously. What we have done? We have taken that this loop should have a definite equivalent capacitance and its value should be C. And see, as it is repeated, so we can replace this whole loop by a capacitance C only. Okay, now I am drawing it, then it will be easier for you. So this point is A. Okay, here it is 2 microfarad, here it is 1 microfarad, and here we can say the loop will come, this portion. So instead of this loop, it is 2, it is 1, and this equivalent we have to take, it is C. Because it is a continuous loop and the continuous capacitance we have taken, it is C. Okay. And as we have taken it C, so the equivalent capacitance of this setup, what setup we have seen here, that will also be C. Why? Because you see, ladder combination means it is repeated. It is repeated continuously. So the equivalent capacitance, whatever it will come here, whenever we have find the capacitance here, the same equivalent capacitance will come. Again, we have to add it, same equivalent capacitance. So this whole setup will have a equivalent capacitance, that is C. So first we have to see what will be the equivalent capacitance of this setup. So equivalent capacitance C dash is equal to, you see, 2 and C, these two are connected in series and 1, it is connected in parallel. So we can add with 1 plus 2 into C by 2 plus C. Exactly that type of thing we have done in case of parallel resistance. Okay, so 1, this is the 1, and these two are connected in series, that means 1 by 2 plus 1 by C. So that we have write it together. Okay, So equivalent resistance will be 1 plus 2C by 2 plus C. Okay. Now here it will be 2 plus C plus 2C by 2 plus C. Right. So as it is 2 plus C, so we can write here 3C plus 2 by 2 plus C. What is it? That is the equivalent resistance of this loop, equivalent capacitance of this loop. And this equivalent capacitance, we have told that value is C dash. But what is C dash? This C dash should be equal to C. Why? Because this is repeated. We have seen from the first, it is repeated continuously. So the equivalent capacitance should be same. That C dash, whatever we have taken, that should be C. So as it is same, so we can write 3C plus 2 by 2 plus C. It should be equal to C. If I multiply, then it will be 3C plus 2 is equals to 2C plus C square. Okay. Now, if this is coming in one side, so it will be C square minus C plus 2. Okay. C square minus C plus 2. That should be equals to 0. It is C minus 2 into C plus 1. If we find the factors, so the value of C, it can be 2 or it can be minus 1. But we know that capacitance cannot be negative. So this minus 1 value we will not take. Only we have to see C equals to 2 microfarad. C equals to 2 microfarad. So that will be the equivalent capacitance of this whole ladder system. Ladder system, I'm just telling you in an easy way. Ladder system means what will be the equivalent capacitance of this first loop? That will be same for the second loop. That will be same for the third loop. It will continue. That's why we have taken that C dash equals to C, because it is a ladder. Okay. This type of question may come for resistance also. Whenever we have to read current electricity, then this same setup can be replaced by the resistances. But the procedure should be same. Okay, I think it is clear. Now we'll go for next numerical. Okay, so what is the next numerical? Let's see. If I'm talking about the next numerical, we can say it is the easiest one. Okay. One diagram is given. It is told a network of 4 10 microfarad capacitors. 4 10 microfarad capacitor means all the capacitors we have taken, C1, C2, C3 and C4, all that capacitors have value 10 microfarad. It is also 10 microfarad. It is also 10 microfarad. And it is also 10 microfarad. Okay. And it is connected with 500 volt supply. Right? As shown in figure, determine the equivalent capacitance. So equivalent capacitance is very easy. So C1, C2, C3, you see C1, C2 and C3, they are connected in series, and along with C4, it is connected in parallel. So we can write C1, C2 and C3 are connected in series. And C4 is connected parallel with them. So as they are connected in series, so equivalent capacitance 1 by Cs will be 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. Okay, so 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3 means 1 by 10 plus 1 by 10 plus 1 by 10. So it is 3 by 10 and Cs is equals to 10 by 3 microfarad, right? And as we are talking about C4, so is Cs we have got. So Cp equals to what? Cs plus C4 as they are connected in parallel. We have to remember that what we have done for resistances, we have to do exactly opposite for capacitance. So Cs equals to 10 by 3 and C4 equals to 10. So it is 40 by 3 microfarad. Okay, so that is the equivalent capacitance and that is our question number 1. This part is over. Now we are talking about the charges. What will be the charges of the capacitor? So as they are connected in parallel, so we can say that what will be the potential in C1, C2 and C3 together, that will be 500 volt. Okay, because if I'm talking about the modified diagram, so modified diagram is this. C1, C2, C3 and here it is C4. All are connected with 500 volt. So across C1, we can assume the potential is V1. Across C2, the potential is V2. And across C3, the potential is V3. Right? And the charges with C1, C2 and C3 will be same as they are connected in series. So we can mention here as C1, C2 and C3 are connected in series, the charge on each will be same. Okay, and that one we have to take, it is Q. Okay, so if I want to find V1, so V1 should be what? That should be Q by C1. If I want to find V2, that should be Q by C2. And if I want to find V3, that should be Q by C3. Because across C1, across C2, across C3, the charge will be same, that is Q. Why? As they are connected in series. And this V1 plus V2 plus V3, this will be equal to 500 volt. Why? Because they are connected with parallelly. So the total potential across these capacitors, that will be 500 volt. Right? So now put the value. So instead of V1, we can write Q by C1 plus Q by C2 plus Q by C3 equals to 500. What is the value of C1, C2 and C3? We know it is 10. So it is Q by 10 plus Q by 10 plus Q by 10 equals to 500. Okay. So if I take a common 3Q by 10 is equals to 500. So 5 equals Q equals to 500 into 10 by 3. And 10 means what? 10 means 10 microfarad. So as we have mentioned, C1 equals to C2 equals to C3 equals to 10 microfarad. So 10 microfarad means 10 into 10 to the power minus 6 farad. Okay, so here we have to mention that 500, we have to mention here 10 into 10 to the power minus 6. Okay, so how many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3, and here it is negative. So we can mention 5 by 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 coulomb. This much amount of charge. Okay, or 5 by 3 means if we do, it will come 1.67 or something like that. We can take nearly about 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 3 coulomb. Okay, so that charge will be same across C1, across C2 and across C3. Okay, now come to the point C4. We can write across C4 potential is 500 volt. So we can mention that charge on C4, let it is Q dash. Okay, so Q dash by 10, because the value of C4 is 10, so it should be 500. How we can write down? We can write Q by C equals to V. By this equation, we can write it. Here also 10 means 10 microfarad. So Q dash equals to 500 into 10 into 10 to the power minus 6. Okay. And if calculated, it is 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 coulomb. I'm sorry. Okay. So the charges on each of the capacitors we have got. So we can write for C1, C2 and C3, the charge will be how much? Q equals to 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 3 coulomb, and in C4 it is Q dash, that is 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 coulomb. Okay, I think it is clear. Coming to numerical number 6, it is told that a 900 picofarad capacitor is charged by 100 volt battery. How much electrostatic energy is stored by this capacitor? So we know for energy, a capacitor, okay, how much energy it is stored? As C, it is given 900 picofarad, okay, and V, it is given 100 volt. So it is very easy to find out, because we know that energy stored in a capacitor E equals to half C V square. Okay, so if I put the value, that is half, C is 900, V square, it is 100 square, and you see 900 picofarad. Okay, so as it is 900 picofarad, so we have to mention it is 10 to the power minus 12. I have told earlier. Okay, so half into 9. Okay, it is 100 and it is 100 squared, means 10 to the power 4. So 9 into 10 to the power 6 into 10 to the power minus 12. So it is 4.5. into 10 to the power minus 6, this much of joule, that is the energy stored on a capacitor of 900 picofarad, right? Now, the second question, this is question number 1. In question number 2, it is told, if the capacitor is disconnected from the battery and connected with another 900 picofarad capacitor, what is the electrical energy stored by the system? Okay, now you see what is done initially. This is a 900 picofarad capacitor and it is connected with 100 volt. It is 100 volt and it is 900 picofarad. Okay, and here we have seen the energy stored, that is 4.5 into 10 to the power 6. Now what is done? Now the system has been changed. This source has been taken out, that is 100 volt. This is a 900 picofarad capacitor. It is again connected to another 900 picofarad capacitor. Okay, then what will happen? Now this capacitor, this is charged. This one, we can say it is charged. And here, whenever you have connected initially, there is no charge. Right? Now, what will happen? Now, as here charge is there, this charge will just try to come and just want to make this another capacitor charge. Up to how much? Assume if the total charge is Q here, this procedure will continue up to that much time when the charge will equally distribute among the capacitors. Why it should be equally distributed? Because we know that two capacitors, capacitance are same. So this process means this charging process, it will continue when it will reach Q by 2 and this one will reach Q by 2. Okay, if instead of 900 picofarad, that is the same capacitance, if you have take another capacitance, then this ratio will be different. We have already done in the extra part of capacitance that the ratio of charge distribution, it depends on the ratio of capacitance. Based on that, the charges are distributed. Okay, so if I am talking about the system, we know that energy, it is being distributed over the two capacitors. Now, what will be the total energy of the system? So the energy, as it is distributed in two capacitors, so the energy will be half. Okay, so initial energy that we have denoted, if we have denoted by E, so now energy E dash, it will be E by 2 because it is separated, okay, on each capacitor. Now the energy will be half into 4.5 into 10 to the power minus 6 joule. So it is 2.25 into 10 to the power minus 6 joule. Now we are coming to the next question. This is the question number 2. Coming to question number 3, where has the remainder energy gone? So as the energy is decreased, we have seen, so where the remainder energy has gone? Simply, whenever the energy just try to flow here, okay, so as the energy starts flowing, some energy is lost as a form of heat energy. Okay, so that energy, that half of the energy in the previous part, it is lost because that energy is been lost as a form of heat energy, because as the charges will come, so some heat energy will produce, because charges come means there will be a current in this loop. So as there is a current flowing there, so there will be heat energy produced. So that's why the energy is lost. Okay. Coming to the last numerical. Okay. So almost we have done almost all the numericals. So we are coming to the last. And if you understand this numerical, then I think you can able to do what kind of numericals are there in your book. Now, this numerical I have taken from the last part, whatever we have discussed, that is dielectric substance. Okay, what it is told, a slab of material dielectric constant K has some area as a plate of parallel plate capacitor but has a thickness of 3d by 4. What is that? So assume this is a capacitor, these two plates are there. Assume it is a positive plate and it's a negative one. The distance between them, it is D, what we have taken earlier also. Now, what we have done? We have introduced one dielectric slab of same area. Means whatever the area of the plates, we have introduced the slab of same area. What is the thickness? Now, the thickness is told 3D by 4. Then how much portion is left? So left portion, we can show that left portion where there is no dielectric. Okay, that should be D minus 3D by 4. Okay, so it is D by 4. So 3D by 4, that is dielectric slab, and D by 4, it is air, completely air. Now what is asked? Okay, where D is the separation of the plates, how is the capacitance change when the slab is inserted between the plates? Now if I am talking about when no slab is inserted, then capacitance C0 equals to, we know that capacitance for a parallel plate capacitor, that is epsilon naught A by D, where A equals to area. Okay, when there is no dielectric slab, so this is the dielectric slab we have inserted here. Now after inserting the dielectric slab, naturally the value of capacitance will be changed. Now how we can able to find the value of capacitance? So we know, what we know, we know that capacitance C is equals to Q by V, that we know. So if the total charge equals to Q on plates. Okay, total charge means here also we have taken Q and here also Q. Whenever it is asked what should be the net charge in a capacitor, I have told in my video earlier also that in a capacitor, net charge, it should always be plus Q minus Q, that means zero. Okay, so total charge means I have told the charge of any one plate, that is Q. Okay, now how we can able to find the V? If I find V, then Q by V we have to do, and then we can able to find the capacitance due to the inserting. So before finding V, we have to find electric field. So electric field in the capacitor, what it will be? Now for D by 4 region, means where there is no slab, this vacant region, this portion, okay, these are vacant portion. So in D by 4 region, electric field is equals to E0, that is the electric field in vacant region. Okay, and for 3D by 4 region, electric field should be E dash. Now what should be the value of E dash? Now we know as the dielectric constant is K, so E dash should be E0 by K. We have already seen in the previous video whenever we have discussed. So as you have inserted a dielectric, the net electric field should be decreased. So if the dielectric constant is K, so in this region, the net electric field will be, the resultant electric field will be E0 by K. If you forget how it is written E0 by K, then go and see the video of dielectrics. Then you can able to understand. Okay, now we have to find out the potential. The potential V equals to E into D. In this case, V equals to E0, it is generated for D by 4, plus E0 by K, that is generated for 3D by 4, right? So as potential equals to electric field into distance, so for different region, the distance are different. Okay, so if I take a common, okay, so E0 into D, if I take a common, So it is 1 by 4 or E0 d by 4 if I take common. It is 1 plus, here it is 3 by k. That is the potential. Okay. Now, potential we have got. Now, talking about the question E0 or E0, what is the value of E0? When we are talking about the value of E0, we know for a capacitor, E0 is equals to epsilon naught by, we have already done it earlier. Okay, so sigma by epsilon naught. Okay, that is the value of E0. What is sigma? The sigma is nothing but Q by A into epsilon naught. This is also explained why we have written sigma by epsilon. That is also explained in video. So I'll suggest that go and see the video again if you are not able to understand how this has come. Okay. Now we have to write the modified form of V. So V equals to, in the place of E0, it is Q by A epsilon naught into D by 4 into 1 plus 3 by k. Okay, that is your V you have written. And now we know that C equals to Q by V. So total charge Q is fixed. Let's write it down there. Okay, C equals to Q by V. So here we have to write, as we know C equals to Q by V. So Q should remain Q, and instead of V, we have already done it, that V equals to Q into D by A epsilon naught 4 by 4 A epsilon naught into 1 plus 3 by K, right? So that we have done just now. So this QQ will be cancelled out. So this will go upward. So 4 A epsilon naught by D into 1 plus 3 by K. Or if you do the calculation, then it should be 4 epsilon naught A by D. It should be K plus 3 by K. So this K will be multiplied at top. So it is 4K by K plus 3 into epsilon naught A by D. Right? Here, epsilon naught A by D, we have done it earlier. We know C0. That means if there is no dielectric slab, then C0 equals to epsilon naught A by D. Okay, so we can write C equals to 4K by K plus 3 into C0. Means whatever your previous capacitance that will be increased by 4K by K plus 3, if you insert a dielectric slab of width 3D by 4. Okay, I think it is clear for you. If you have done this numericals, I think you can able to understand how the capacitors numericals you have to do. Okay.